Hey everybody, Shinobi's here. Here today to show you how to use virtual audio cables and how I use virtual audio cables to be able to grab the audio from TeamSpeak or Skype while I'm live streaming. So today I'm going to kind of show you how to do that because I've had a few issues with using multiple repeaters with virtual audio cables. So today I'm going to show you how to use multiple virtual audio cable instances without actually having to run multiple repeaters. So what you need to do first of all, of course, is grab a copy of virtual audio cables. So to get a copy of virtual audio cables, you're going to go to software.muzzychinko.net/english/vac.htm and purchase, and then there's download trial version. So you're going to want to download the trial version first of all to give it a shot. And then as soon as you save this, you're going to want to, install it. So just make sure you remember where you saved the file. And then once you got the file saved, you want to open it up. And then you're going to want to go into your setup. Now, you're going to want to either install this as the 32-bit version, which is this standard setup here, or you might actually, depending on your operating system, want to use a 64-bit. I actually have a 64-bit operating system with Windows 8.1, so I use the 64-bit system. As soon as you've got it all installed, there's nothing difficult about it. You just next until it's done. Just remember where it installs to. So once you have that installed, first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go to the folder where your virtual audio cables has been installed. What you're going to want to do is then you're going to want to open up this virtual audio cable control panel, which is right here. I'll open that up again for you guys. Okay, so you're going to want to open up your virtual audio cable control panel, and you're going to want to make sure that your cables here reads 3. So as long as your cables is reading 3 and you see 3 cables here, then everything's copacetic. That's exactly what you want. You can go ahead and click exit on that. If it does not say that you have 3, you're going to want to change this to 3, hit set, and then go ahead and exit. Okay, now that we have the 3 virtual audio cables that you need, you're going to want to go into your control panel on your machine, and then once you get into your control panel, you're going to want to do a search or type for sound, and then you're going to want to manage audio devices. Okay, so once you have your manage audio devices here, then what you're going to do is you're going to set line 1, you're going to set that as your default playback device. Okay, then you're going to go into your recordings, and in your recordings, of course, you're going to set your whatever your default microphone is. I have a couple, of course. I have one on my camera, and then of course I have one here on my headset. So I have my headset mic set as the primary microphone, and then what I did line 2, you're going to want to go into line 2, and then you're going to have it listen to line 1. Okay, so the reason you're going to do this is you're going to have, so all of your audio from Windows is now being played into line 1, okay? So then you're going to have line 2 listen to line 1, okay? And then you're going to use line 2 to go out to your stream. Okay, then the last thing that you're going to do is you're going to open up one of these audio repeaters. Okay, and you're going to change the audio repeater. Okay, so once you load up your repeater, make sure that you have it set from line 1, which is where all of your Windows audio is going to. And then you're going to want your wave out to be whatever speakers you want. For me, I have it going to my USB headset. For you, you could have it go to your standard speakers. It completely is up to your personal preferences. And then what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go back into your control panel and manage sound. And then you're going to want to go into the speakers that you chose. For me, it's my headset, so I'm going to go into the properties of my headset. And then I'm going to go to the advanced tab. And that's going to tell me what the audio quality is being pumped into my headset. And you want to make sure that these match. Otherwise, you're going to have some audio issues. So I'm going to set my sample rate to 4,100 hertz, and then I'm going to set my bits per sample to 16, just like I have here. And then I'm going to set my buffer to 400, and the number of buffers is fine at 12. And then you want to set your priority to high. Anything lower than high, I tend to have a little bit of an audio issue. And then you're just going to hit start. Okay, so once you have this started, you should kind of take a check and look at your overflows and underflows. If you start noticing that you have a bunch of underflows, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to increase this total buffer in milliseconds, okay? So if your underflows starts counting up here, this is your counter, then you're going to want to increase the total buffer in milliseconds. If you start having a whole lot of overflows, you're going to want to decrease your total buffer in milliseconds. And that will kind of, so you want to try to keep these at zero if at all possible. And that will make sure that your audio stays working properly. Okay, so now that we have this set up, we don't want to have to go through this every time. This is a lot to remember to do every single time. So what we're going to do now is we're going to create a .bat file. And how we're going to do that is we're going to go open up a Notepad file. And then in Notepad, what we're going to do is actually I already have one created, so let me show that here. Okay, so you're just going to want to open up your Notepad, and I'll put this down in the description as well, so you guys can actually see the full description of how this works. So you're going to want to open up a Notepad, and then what you're going to want to put in there is the location you're going to want to start minimized your audio repeater, okay? And then you're going to want to put the directory of where your audio repeater is. For me, it's on my E drive in a folder called Virtual Audio Cables, and then audiorepeater.exe. Okay. Now we want to select our inputs. For the input, it should be your line one virtual audio cable, and you want to keep those in parentheses. And then we select our output. Now the output is a little more difficult because, as you noticed, or as you're probably noticing, the output here is my USB headset, but it kind of cuts off a little bit here and doesn't have the end of that parentheses there. And that's because what you want to do is you want to look here in your virtual audio cables to see exactly what it says in the listing here. So for this, for my headset, it's speakers, parentheses two, but then it cuts off at heads. So that's what we have in here for our output. Then we want to set our buffer. Now, like I said, the buffer is going to vary depending on your machine and your specs. So for me, the buffer at 400 milliseconds works perfectly. And then I have my sampling rate. It, like I said, you get that from your speaker settings at 44,100. It'll automatically start in 16-bit stereo mode, so you don't really need to set that. And then the priority I have set to high, which is actually a Windows setting, so that you know more processing speed is or it's given a higher priority to be processed before other programs because, you know, your audio is important, especially if you're streaming. Okay. And then the last thing is auto start. So then it's going to force the program to start up automatically. Okay, so now that we've created this file here, we just want to save this in a location that we can find again. And you just want to save it as VAC.bat. Make sure that you change that to all files because otherwise it'll add the .txt extension to the end of your file. So set that to VAC.bat. Make sure that you can find the file for later because we're going to use it here in just a second so that then when your computer first comes on, you never have to set this. This will automatically come up with your machine. Okay, so now that we have that file saved, we are going to go back into the control panel. And under the control panel, what we're going to want to do now is we're going to find our scheduled tasks. And then your scheduled tasks. What we're going to want to create a basic task. We're going to call this virtual audio cables, just so that we can remember what it is. We're going to hit next, and then we're going to do when the computer starts, or when I log on, actually. I'm sorry. We're going to do when I log on next. And then Then we're going to want to start a program, next. And now we're going to want to browse to where the virtualaudiocables.bat file was that we just saved. So for me, that was in e-virtualaudiocables-vac.bat, and I'm gonna hit open. Okay, so we don't need to add any arguments to this. It'll automatically reset all of those in the actual text file. So we don't have anything to do for that. So then we're gonna hit next. And then in this last dialog, you're going to want to click Open Properties dialog box for this task when I finish, and then click Finish. What we're going to want to do is down here, we want to make sure that we check this Run with Highest Privileges checkbox. If you don't check this, as soon as you log into your computer each time, what will happen is you will get this dialog box that opens up that says, do you want to give permission to repeater.exe to run as an administrator? If you do check this box, it will automatically give it permission, so you don't have to mess with that every single time. Your computer will just start like normal, and you'll already be set up to be able to start streaming. And also, it's not going to affect anything when you're running your PC doing regular games or whatever. You're still going to hear everything like normal. This just gives you the option to where whenever you do want to stream, you don't have to go through any kind of setup for your audio. The audio has already been taken care of. Okay, so now that we have all that set up, what we're going to want to do is make sure that we go into our either Skype or we go let's go into our Skype real quick. So once you open up your Skype, you're gonna, for me it's on Windows 8. So for you, this might be a little bit different. But for Windows 8, you're gonna wanna go into your settings, and then you're gonna wanna go into your options, and then you wanna to go out to, or you could even just use default device, and then everything's gonna go out to the stream as well. And then on your microphone, you're just gonna leave your microphone where it is. Okay, and then let's say that you're running TeamSpeak. I will show you the TeamSpeak settings. Let's get rid of that. Okay, let's bring this over here. Okay, so on TeamSpeak, you're gonna wanna go into your settings and then your options, and you're gonna wanna go into your playback, and then you want your playback to go into line one, okay? So everything goes into your default device, which is your line one, and then you still capture your standard microphone. And this seems to me to be the simplest way to do this. So now, then the last thing is that on your streaming software, you're gonna go into, like on XSplit, you're gonna go into your tools and then general settings. And you're gonna change your output to line two. So everything that goes out to the stream that you want everyone to hear is on line two. Everything that you would like to hear is going to come into your default device or line one. Have your TeamSpeak set. Okay, now that we've set up TeamSpeak to line one and your Skype to line one, what you're going to want to do then is you're going to want to change your XSplit or your OBS output speaker to line two. Okay, so we set the outputs to line two. Your inputs are going to be on line one. Either your TeamSpeak or your Skype are going to be set to line one, and then you just use your standard microphone as the input devices on everything. So including on TeamSpeak or TeamSpeak, XSplit, Skype, OBS, all of them, your microphone is still going to be used like normal. So that concludes my video this evening for how to use virtual audio cables and stream and bring in extra audio such as TeamSpeak and Skype. Thank you all for your time. If you have any other questions, please feel free to leave them down in the comments below. Thank you.